thought he was about to shoot me and throw me in some bushes or take me down to that water and throw me in. Like, I was like, what the f*** did I get into? Basically, my child is sleeping, my little baby, and I did my makeup, so I'm like, let me film a story time. I just filmed my postpartum what worked, what didn't work for me video, so if you're interested in that, please go check it out. But right now, I'm going to give y'all a story time. I'm back on it with my story times, and this is a time that this dude pulled out a gun on me. Like, this is no cap. Like, I swear to God, this happened, and y'all, like, I want to say it was... Oh, my baby's scared, Ryan. Okay, we're good to go. So, yeah, like I said, this was, like, crazy. It was such a crazy experience for me. This is the first time this had ever happened to me. So I'm just going to give you a little bit of insight on what happened and, like, why he did what he did. Like, why he pulled out a gun on me. This video clearly is about to be demonetized, but it's all good because... You know, sometimes I'm gonna take my losses. It is what it is. I gotta tell y'all the story. So this happened to me when I was 18 years old, and okay, I got kicked out of my house. I was living with my dad and his wife. What is this hair? Let me break it down for y'all real quick. I turned 18 in April. My birthday is in April. In the summertime, this is when everything went down, when it happened. That summer, I got kicked out of my house in Harlem. I was living with my dad and my stepmom, and you know, if y'all listen to my other story times, especially about the story times about, like, how my dad found out I was having sex and, like, you know, me and Chubbs and, like, that whole relationship and, like, you know, all that stuff that happened with my parents, like, you would know that at that time in my life, me and my parents weren't that close. Like, we just was, like, constantly butting heads, you know, and I was 18, y'all. Like, I just thought I could be a rebel, and... I wanted to be a rebel. I was tired of following the rules because I always followed the rules, and I just felt like I was being seen as like a bad kid all the time when I was nowhere near as bad as like my friends, okay? Like, not even close. I was such a good kid compared to them, but you would never think that, you know, coming from my parents at that time. I wound up going to live with my mom. My mom lives in New Jersey, and my mom has always been, at that time, like, in high school, she has always been, like, the cool parent, you know what I'm saying? Like, she was younger than my dad, so I feel like she was just less conservative, and she just kind of always went with, like, the, you know, like, the flow of things happening now. So, like, she was always, like, down with, like, you know, the new sneakers. She was always down with, like, the name brands. Like, my dad would be like, no, I'm not spending $100 on some sneakers for you. I would just go to my mom, and my mom would be like, oh, what, you want those Timbs? You want those Jordans? You want those Air Max? I got you. So I always looked at my mom at that time like, yo, like, that's a cool parent. Like, fine, I'll go live with my mom, whatever. However, my mom don't play, so like, don't think for any second like I cannot talk back to my mom. My mom just don't play, all right? But that's you know, neither here or there. But I, you know, I just didn't get over my mom. She just was like, cool, if that makes sense. So I was like, yeah, whatever, I'll go live with my mom. Like, fine. Like, you know, I was pissed because all my friends was in Harlem and the Bronx and like in New York City, but you know, my mom wasn't that far. My mom lived in Jersey, and in the part of Jersey that she lived in, it's probably like 15 minutes if you drive with no traffic into Harlem, into the Bronx too. Like, actually, it's like super close over the George Washington Bridge. You know, if y'all from New York, you know what I'm saying. Like, it's like mad close. I'm not gonna tell you where because my mom still lives in Jersey, so I ain't gonna tell y'all that. But you know, she just lives mad close, and I can just hop on the bus real quick. It takes me like 15 minutes to get to like the A train, and then I could do whatever I want. On top of it, my mom didn't clock me. So, like, she just was like, yo, tell me where you're going. You know, I keep your cell phone on if I need you. Let me know where you at all times. You know, but I trust you. Because my mom knew I was a good kid. Like, she knew I'm not a follower. Like, I just did what I needed to do. So, she always let me do what I want. So, I got kicked out of my house. I went and I lived and I moved in with my mom, okay? Now, that summer, I had a job, but which is another reason why my mom was so lenient with me, because I was always working. I was always working. So when I wasn't working, it was like, yo, can I please hang out with my friends? And she would never tell me no, because like I was always doing what I needed to do. I didn't ask her for money. I never asked for anything. This particular time, I wanted to go back to New York and hang out with my homegirl. And I don't remember what I named her, but we're gonna name this girl. I spoke about her before in one of my Chubbs videos. This was like my ace. This was like my best friend. This was my girl that I would always like chill with and get in trouble with. But like I was always chilling with her. Like she, me and her just knew what was up. Like when we would be out chilling, we're just gonna name her Passion. Me and my homegirl Passion, like we was like this always together, and we just knew what was up. We was always trying to hang out in the streets, honestly. Like when I did live in Harlem and we would hang out, I would make up these elaborate excuses to say like, oh, I'm gonna go to the movies because I had to give my dad like a full-on story on what I was doing, where I was going, who I was going with. And I would make up these full-on stories, and me and my girl Passion would literally just walk around Harlem and hang out with dudes on the block and like this area of Harlem where the Diplomats used to hang out, which is, if you know who the Diplomats is, you know it's like basically like Cam, Jewel, Santana, like all those like artists or whatever. They used to hang out in a certain area of Harlem all the time, and we would always walk by because I had like this crazy crush on Cameron and she had this crazy crush on Jewel Santana, and we just thought like we got it like that. We're like, yeah, we in high school, but we gonna bag these dudes and we gonna walk around the area because they always was in Harlem. Like we saw them so many times, okay? Like, but the funny thing is that we are not like groupies, so even though we had like these crazy crushes on them, like when we did see them, we would never say nothing to them. But anyway, and I think Cam was with Juju at that time. I feel like he was with Juju anyway, so I wouldn't say nothing, and then Passion would never say nothing to Jewel's. But we wound up being really, really cool friends with one of their really, really cool friends. And his street name, I can't say it, so I'm gonna say his street name was Blade. Let's just say his street name was Blade, okay? At first, I think he wanted to holler at us, but when he realized we were young, but we were mad cool, he just used to look at us like his little sisters. You know, he would always look out for us, always. Like, he was so, so cool, so nice. And we would just be chilling with him on the block all the time, you know? Like, that was just our homie. And, like, we'd just hang out with him. When we had nothing to do, we would literally just walk all the way to that area of Harlem and just chill with him. So this one particular day this summer, while I was 18, I keep about to say their names. Blade either contacted me or Passion, I can't remember which one, because he was super cool with both of us. He contacted us and he let us know that Dipset, aka the Diplomats, they always do like a Dipset barbecue every single year. So this day was the day that they was doing the Dipset barbecue. So he hit us up and he was like, yo, come through, we're having the barbecue, and you know, like, just come through and chill like you always do. So it was like, yes, let's do this, let's get cute, because I'm about to bag me some Cam. And Passion was like, I'm about to bag me Jewel's, like, let's look real, real cute, okay? And y'all, like, okay, so there is this guy, what was it, Freeze? It wasn't Freeze. I can't remember what it was. Damn, my memory sucks sometimes. But this was back in the day when they had like DVDs out all the time. And Sub-Zero. Okay, so Sub-Zero DVDs, he will always capture like hood street events or whatever. And it's funny because he was there that day and he definitely caught me on video. I don't know why I did it. I thought I was so cute, but when I look back at that video, because I looked back a few years ago, and I don't have it now, I'm sorry. I would love to show y'all, but I look crazy. But everybody thought I look cute. I got so many hollers. And this day was no different. So many people tried to holler at me. It was crazy. But I was like, you know, deading people left and right, because I was there for Cam and my girl was there for Jewel's, and we had tunnel vision. We didn't see nobody else, all right? But we didn't talk to them. Same as always, we never said nothing to them. We just was hanging out with Blade and his homeboys, which was our homeboys, and we was just chilling. So we was there literally all day at this Dipset barbecue, and it was fun. You know, it was hot. I didn't get my man Cam. Passion didn't get her man Joel, so we was like, you know what, honestly, like, we're kind of tired anyway, like, we've been out all day long, like, we was there from, like, the whole time, you know what I'm saying, like, I was just done, I was tired of being around all the hood people, you know what I'm saying, like, I was ready to go home, so, you know, it's dark anyway, and, you know, it's just time for some young girls to go home. So we're all making our way to go home, and we're walking and saying bye to Blade and his friends and everybody, and we're about to leave, and these biker boys come, and you know, biker boys be looking dope, like, they be looking mad dope, you know, they're just like lined up chilling, like, you know, making noise, doing their little tricks and street thing or whatever in the hood, like, it's dope. So like, we're watching, we're like, wow, that's dope, that's cool. So this guy comes up to me and he's like grabbing me, he's like, oh my, like, you look good, like, let me holler at you, blah blah blah. And that's always what they do in New York. All right, go to New York, no matter how you look, they're trying to holler at you. Okay, so I'm just looking at him like, he ain't kind of cute, but I don't really want to talk to you. And you know, he's just trying, and he got his little swag, and he was cute. Let's just name him Devante. I don't know why, but let's name him Devante. So Devante is trying to holler at me, and eventually I just give in because he was kind of cute. He had a motorcycle. I thought that was pretty cool. He was older than me, obviously. He held his own, obviously. Like, he just was like screaming, like, you know what, I'm your type, Lisa, so just give me your number and stop fighting it. So I gave him my number and I dipped. And I didn't expect to really hear from him. The next day he hits me up, and you know, I'm in Jersey, y'all. Jersey is boring. All right, if I didn't go to New York, I was bored. I was working, but I didn't really do nothing else in Jersey. I only went to New York to hang out, so I was kind of bored. So I was entertaining him, and I'm letting him know, like, you know, I live in Jersey right now. I was just chilling with my boy and my homegirl, and you know, I don't think I'm gonna be able to see you. And he was just like, why not? And I was like, because, like, I'm not about to be coming to New York to see you. Like, I don't know you like that. And he was just like, okay, Lisa, I drive, I can come to you. And I was just like, damn. So Devante not only has a motorcycle, but Devante got a car too. I was like, if you want to come see me, then come see me, that's no problem. He was only, y'all, like, I swear, he was only like in his early 20s. So I was just looking at him like, you must be slanging, like, what you really do? Because how you got a car and a motorcycle, like, what do you do? I told him, yeah, I was like, fine, that's no problem, you can come hang out with me on Saturday, which was like a couple of days, like, it was like basically the following week. And I did tell my mom everything that was going on, and I said, hey, I want to hang out with this guy, you know, like, you know, is it okay? Like, what do you think about this? And she was like, girl, listen, as long as I know where you're at, like, it's all good. My mom said, listen, it's no problem. As long as I know where you're at, like, sure, you can hang out with him. Like, okay, I don't see the harm in it. So she wound up taking me to a McDonald's, not too far from where we live, but far enough that, like, he can't find out where I live. You know what I'm saying? And then I had to go to work afterwards anyway. So he wound up meeting me at this McDonald's, and he pulls up, he pulls in, and you know, he was looking fine. I was like, damn, like, he is cute, like, ooh. Mom left, you know, she felt like everything was good. I was in the public, you know, and he was grown, he had a car, and like, she just, my mom just don't worry about me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can hold my own, so she was not worried. And me and him, we're at McDonald's, and he gets my food, and I'm just like liking this, you know, because I just, at that point, I only really dealt with Chubbs as a boyfriend. And you know, Chubbs, he was very chivalrous, he was very gentlemanly, but to see an older guy and who got his life together already, as far as like, for me, in my eyes, like, having a car, having a motorcycle, obviously he got money. I didn't ask him what he did because I just assumed he was slanging. Like, I didn't want to, you know, get myself in any mix or actually have him tell me, like, oh, you don't need to know what I do, you know what I'm saying? Like, so I didn't even ask. But he was being a real gentleman, so I was like, okay, like, this is cool. So we're talking and we're just like getting to know each other, and it was interesting. This was like my first real date at McDonald's, which was crazy. And we're talking about each other's past relationships and like what's going on. And I asked him, I was like, hey, you know, like, what happened with you and your ex? Like, he said that he was in a serious relationship for like 6 years. And I'm just like, what's going on? Like, what happened with that? Like, how come you're not with her no more? And he was just like, she's crazy. Like, she's crazy. I can't deal with her. Like, she brings out the worst in me, and, like, I just can't do it. And I was like, oh, all right. Okay, cool. Like, no problem. So we're just talking. And then I wound up asking him, I don't know why I asked this question, but I just asked him, I was like, hey, have you ever hit a female before? And, like, literally, I don't know why I asked that question, but I'm happy I did. So he looked at me, he was just like, why you ask me that? And I was like, I just wanted to know. Like, you know, I asked that question because me and Chubbs used to, like, fight. Like, we used to physically fight. Like, I used to hit him, and, like, he wouldn't hit me back, but he would, like, you know, push me, or, like, you know, shove me, or, like, duff me, like mush me, I'm saying, or, like, you know, like, he'll pull my hair because I used to pull his hair, like, stuff like that. So I just felt like I didn't want to be in a toxic relationship or deal with any toxicity like that, any physical, any relationship that can get physical, I didn't want to deal with. So when he looked at me like that, I kind of figured, like, he did. And, you know, that kind of was like, oh, damn, like, everything was working for you. So I was like, okay, so, like, what happened? Like, it's no big deal, I'm not judging you, like, just what happened? So he wound up telling me that he was at home, and him and his girl was just chilling in bed, laying down, everything was good, everything was great, and he got up to take a shower. And when he got up to take a shower, she went through his phone. And when she went through his phone, like, she obviously saw some other girls messaging him, and, like, you know, it just went out, it just got out of hand, and she got mad, she started yelling at him, and she wound up hitting him. And I think I want to say she punched him in the face, or, like, whatever she did, like, it blacked him out, is what he said, and he wound up punching her in the face. Like, so that shocked me, because I was like, ooh, you didn't just push her, you didn't just, like, you know, like hit her on the arm or nothing. Like, you went in her face, dude. Like, this is not somebody that I want to deal with. So I guess, like, my face told it all, and I kind of was just like, all right, like, that's okay, all right, I get it. Like, I didn't want to act too, like, scared. I wasn't scared, but I didn't want to act too, like I was falling back already, because I legit in my head was like, done, I'm never talking to this dude again. But I didn't want to, like, you know, give that impression off. But I did. I probably asked, like, two more questions, and I was like, all right, I gotta go. I think I gotta go to get ready for work. So I'm gonna head out. You know, like, maybe I'll talk to you another time. And he was just like, oh, listen, I'll drive you home, or I'll drive you to work. And I was like, no, it's okay, like, don't worry about it, like, my mom's gonna come get me and whatever. And he was just like, don't be silly, like, I will drive you to work. And I was like, okay, fine. Like, I couldn't argue with him. And then at that point I was just like, shit, I don't want him to hit me. So we get in his car, and he's saying some other stuff to me, but I kind of was, like, dazed out. I was just thinking about the fact that he hit this girl, and I was kind of like, disappointed, you know what I mean? Like, I was like, damn, I just met Devontae's fine ass. He got a car, he got a motorcycle, he came all the way to Jersey to chill with me, you know what I'm saying? Like, we had great conversation, but he hit females, and I cannot deal with that. So I was like in a daze. So I'm looking at him, and I'm like, I gave him the address, so I told him where it was, and he winds up, you know, moving the car, and I'm just like dazed out. Next thing I notice, he pulls into, like, this park area, like, it was like a dead end park area, and I can see it right now. There was, like, grass in front of us. There was nothing next to us. No cars behind us. I don't even know how he found this place. It was like a dead end area-ish. And he looks at me, he parks the car, and he was like, so, and I looked up, was like, where are we? I didn't even let him get anything. I was like, where are we? Why are we here? And he was just like, oh, we're just chilling. I was like, I just told you I have to go to work. Like, why are you, like, what are we doing? And where are we? Like, what's going on? Like, you need to, like, I need to go. I don't want to be here. And he was just like, chill. Like, you scared? I was like, I'm not scared, but why am I here? And I don't even know you like that, dude. Like, I probably am scared. Like, yes, I'm scared. Yes. And he was like, come on. And I was like, no, I'm not scared, but I want to go. Like, why? Like, what are we doing here? There's nobody here, you know. And you know what's funny, now that I'm older, now that I think about it, I wonder if he thought that I was just gonna give him some booty. Like, I wonder if he thought, like, I was just gonna, like, open my legs to him, or, like, start making out with him and just, like, give it up, like, quick like that. I don't know what he thought, but that's probably what he thought, you know. But I'm thinking the fact that he hit this girl. So I'm just like, no, I'm not scared. Like, come on, I wanna go. Like, I'm trying to be like a tough girl, right? Yo, tell me why. He just looks at me like this. And he's like, why are you scared? And then he puts his arm behind. So I'm in the passenger seat and he's in the driver's seat. And he reaches behind and he goes under the in the car seat. And he comes back and he puts it to my head like this. And I'm sitting there because like I didn't look to see what he was doing. I just saw his arm go, you know, and I felt it. He went behind the seat and he puts the gun to my head while I'm looking straight. And he's like, why are you scared? You scared now? Y'all. I thought this dude was going to kill me. I thought I was with a fucking psychopath. I thought I was with a fucking killer. I thought my life was over. I thought he was about to shoot me and throw me in some bushes or take me down to that water and throw me in. Like, I was like, what the fuck did I get into? I have a gun to my head as I'm sitting in a car with a dude that I don't even know his last name. Okay, and my mom thought I was in McDonald's. Now I'm not in McDonald's. Like, y'all, this is crazy. Like, literally, he had the gun to my head. And then he was like, so you scared now? And I was like, are you serious? And like, he put it down and he put it like right in the, you know, that middle part of the armrest. And he's just like, you know, he just put it down. He didn't even hold it, nothing. And I looked at it and I looked at him and I was like, yo, you're crazy. Like, you're crazy. And I shouldn't even have said that. I shouldn't have said nothing. I don't even know what I should have said. And he starts laughing. He was just like, oh, you thought I was gonna shoot you? He's like, chill out. Like, I'm not gonna shoot you. Like, shut up. And I'm like, in my head, I'm like, you're fucking crazy. Like, did you think that was funny? Because that shit is not fucking funny. You might as well have fucking shot me because that's not funny. I'm sorry, my baby girl's crying. But I was just done. I was so over it. And a part of me was scared. I'm not even gonna front, but a part of me was mad. Like, I was just mad I got myself in that situation. And I don't know what it is about me and like dangerous situations or situations where like guns are pointed at me. Because if you watch the video on my house being raided, yeah, guns was in my face and my stupid ass was not even scared. I don't be scared like that. Like, I just be like more mad or like more mad. I'm like, I was so pissed. Like, I'm like, why, how dare you put a gun to my head, nigga? Like, if you're not about to shoot that shit, like, shit. I was just so pissed. So I kind of just looked at him and I was like, you're really crazy. He's just there laughing like a fucking psychopath that he is. And I said, okay, you're gonna make me late for work. So are you gonna take me to work now or not? Like, are you just gonna sit here and play with this gun in front of me and be weird and dumb and shit? And he was like, okay, I'll take you to work. And he puts the gun back under the seat under me, which is like, thank God we didn't get pulled over, because Lord knows what would have happened, you know, if I would have got locked up or if he would have tried to say that gun was my, yo, like, oh, so crazy. And I was only 18 at this time. Whatever. So Devontae winds up taking me to work. You know, I said my goodbye. I tried not to freak him out and like act all like pissed, but I was pissed. And you know, I just said bye, thanks for McDonald's, like, it was cool chilling with you, you know, I'll talk to you whenever I talk to you. And he was like, all right, bye, peace out. You know, he did hit me up after that, which I completely ignored every single message. And you know, I guess he just was not into me like that either. I guess he realized I wasn't gonna give it up quick, or you know, like, maybe I was too young for him. I don't know what it was, but I never spoke to him again. I never saw him again. He could have came to my job, but I guess he probably just was like, it's not that serious, because he lived in Brooklyn. Like, he was from Brooklyn, and you know, to come all the way to Jersey to get a little 18-year-old that's not even into you or like is down for that, like, I guess he wasn't feeling it either. And yeah, that was the first time I had guns pointed at me, and that was the first time I had a gun literally on my temple. On my temple. Okay, not the, it was this one, because he was right here. It was right here. I was like, y'all, this is crazy. Like, what the fuck? What the fuck? But anyway, that's the story. The first time that I had a gun pointed to my head. And y'all, like, literally, y'all need to be careful. Y'all don't know people. And I could have wound up dead. He could have wound up killing me. He could have wound up dragging me into a bush. But it wouldn't have happened because I'm a fighter, so, you know. And at the end of the day, my mom did know where I was at. Technically, I feel like she probably would have been able to find me. I can handle myself. I got myself in some crazy situations when I think about it, honestly. Like, in situations that could have ended up really, really bad, like this one right here. And that's why I'm here telling my story, so that you guys, you know, if you guys are young, you know, like, just know what you get into. Like, learn from me. Learn from other YouTubers that tell their stories. You know, it's entertainment and it's fun. But, you know, take it as a lesson learned. Because we done been there, done that. And, you know, we want you guys to be safe. So, that's another reason why I'm telling my story. I just want to share that with you. Anyway, so, guys, I'm going to go now because my baby girl is, like, waking up. And she keeps, like, crying. And it's just time for her to eat. So, I'm gonna let y'all go. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this story. I know I talk really fast. If you need me to slow it down, I'll slow it down. But I'll be talking a lot and long, so that's why I talk so fast. And if you want to get an insight of my life right now, my millennial life as a mother, as a wife, please check out my channel, The Saints. It's me, my husband, and my baby girl. And we have a lot of vlogs on there, a lot of fun stuff on there. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. Make sure you subscribe to that channel. Turn my post notifications on. Check us out on Instagram. And just, you know, just keep it real, keep it love, keep it support. I love you guys so much. Keep it geek, freak, chic, and sleek, though. But most importantly, keep it unique. Bye, lovies. See you in my next video. Oh, 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 oh. Okay, bye.